before we introduce, let me just ask to all of you that are all of you have registered, like all the 98 students, or there are still some students left? When is the last day of registration?
7th.
Okay. So there are few more days, but this is a core course, so I believe that all the registered third year, first semester, second semester students have to register for this course. Okay, all right. So this before I introduce the course objective or course outline, let me have some informations from you. Is where if you be taught earlier semester about any of this process modeling course or process simulation or related course, or this is the first time you are seeing this course? Yes, no?
Yes. So we have a bit of MATLAB simulations in IPC, nothing otherwise.
I see. So that was just in the previous semester, third year, first semester. I see. So this course, and one more, have you been taught about anything related to MATLAB or Aspen, or you have just seen the applications?
No, sir, nothing of that sort has been taught particularly.
Okay, all right. Take it. So so this let me just briefly tell you about what is this course is all about, and then slowly we'll introduce about the scope and objective, what are the different textbook, what are the contents that we are going to cover, and gradually we'll unfold ourselves. So this course, as the name suggests, it's a computer aided process engineering. Names are coming from many universities or many chemical engineering curriculum. They follow this name. At the same time, they also modify. Sometimes people will call process modeling and simulation, computer process simulations, computer process modeling and simulation, like that. So this course is basically solving, formulating and solving the process processes. Formulation of a process and computation through analytical or numerical technique. So these are the two parts. First is the you have to first model a process. So what are the different processes that you commonly see in chemical engineering applications? For example, this distillation column, or let's say heat exchanger. You have all studied the heat exchanger design and heat exchanger operations you have seen. So this applications goes to this organization of the equations or understanding of the processes through that particular application, let's say heat exchanger operations. So what computer aids, I'm trying to explain the meaning computer aided. So earlier days, this when the chemical process industries started long back ago, and there whenever the any description of the processes was supposed to obtain, they used to write they used to derive the governing laws, governing principles through mathematical expressions. Is it okay, Debajyoti? Okay, all right. So let me add one student. Okay, so where this computer aids or computer is requirement is coming. So in earlier days, people used to write the equations. Equations mean, see, all these chemical processes that actually occur, they occur through some physical governing phenomena. So the beauty of this process modeling and simulation is that you are able to clearly describe the processes through unambiguous and clear way in the form of mathematical relations, mathematical expressions. You have all seen the overall mass balance or species balance, enthalpy balance, like in different courses. So these balance equations, as invariably the term coming, the equations, it relates to mathematical expressions. Now these mathematical expressions, the next stage is mathematical expression. You have to organize the different equations through information flow diagram. So this terminology I am using, but I will explain through different examples in subsequent classes. So this, if you can arrange these equations in a natural ordering sequence, let's say cause and effect relations, so that helps you to understand the process and to solve for the variables or to solve for the unknowns. And if you go like this natural ordering or cause and effect relations in the form of an information flow diagram, then the solution that you will obtain will be stable. The computer applications, if you get the solution, that will be stable. Now, in terms of in the beginning, I introduced that there are two broad things, that is the formulation and then there is the computation. So the formulation part actually requires the knowledge of the problem definition, the physics of the problem, that means the theory or the governing laws or phenomena that is actually occurring or that is actually describing the process. Then the next step is the equations arrangement. Basically, you, for each of these processes or for each of these governing laws or governing phenomena, you actually describe, you actually represent them through the form of mathematical relations. Now this part, these three steps that I have already discussed, I will show in the form of block diagram in subsequent slide. But immediately I'm trying to incept something in your mind so that when you see them in the form of block diagram, you will be able to relate. And then finally, the information flow diagram, that is a very important concept in this course, where you will see that how this equations are actually arranged in the form of natural ordering, that means natural cause and effect relations. So after doing this whole steps or whatever the 3-4 steps I have actually talked about, this actually is a part of problem formulations.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Are you sharing any presentation?
No, I'm not presenting anything, but I'll present something slightly later. Was that your question? I mean,
Yes, sir. Like, yeah. You were saying okay. Something. I thought there are some slides.
Yeah. No. The slides are not here. I'll show two document where I have written something, and after I explain this, I'll show to you.
Okay.
Okay. So that is the first part. That is the problem formulations. The second main step is the problem computations or solution to the problem, right? So that solution to the problem that requires some engineering approach. Now engineering approach means you have to use your judgment, you have to use your common sense as well as engineering judgment. That means when to ignore some term, when to add some term, when to assume something. So these are some kind of skill set that you will also be able to learn through this course, and while solving for many problems, you will automatically gain this skill. So this through this judgment, you will actually find the insight into the solution route. That means, suppose you have you are solving a problem, a process problem, let's say which encounters both heat transfer as well as reaction engineering concept. We'll see some examples afterwards, but typically this course will leave you will help you to explore the four or other five major subjects that you study in chemical engineering, where you actually require this computer-aided simulations or computerized solutions of that particular problem. And these courses are basically, you have already studied fluid flow. Mass transfer, I don't know, maybe you have studied. Heat transfer, you have studied. Reaction engineering, you will study in the next semester. And then process dynamics and control. So these all five subjects, you will see that invariably they require the solution through computer. But here one thing must be remembered, that the computer solution is not the only option. Rather, it helped you to gain more insight to solve more complex problem, because chemical process industries typically deals with many complex problems which are non-linear in nature and which requires simultaneous solutions. It is not a single variable or single algebraic or a single differential equation. It is a simultaneous, non-linear and coupled equations, where you will see both algebraic, differential, both partial and ordinary. So you can understand the complexity of the problem. You can understand the increasing degree of freedom, basically the high degree of problem, high degree problem, you can also say. And this is actually the trend in industry. This, as you can see, that people are more relying on automation. Yeah, people are more trying to go for automations, automatic and many of these industry, let's say power industry, coal industry, where people do not want to rely much on the, or not rely, it is basically the life becomes more easier if you can have a simulation tool available at the same time where actual experimental setup or actual experiments is actually occurring. Actual, let's say, distillation operation is going on, but at the same time, if you can see the process that is actually occurring in the plant, but you can also see in the computer the same thing. That is the basically the simulation. So I'm trying to connect you through the simulation and experiment, right? So it offers two, three huge advantages when you can have both the simulations available with you or the processes that is actually occurring in the industry, but you can also modify, you can also change some parameter, you can also see the effects of disturbance, effect of perturbation into the problem, into the processes that is actually occurring. So basically it is a representation. So simulation, computer simulation, is basically representation of the processes which is occurring physically in real sense in the industry or in laboratory. You are trying to replicate, you are trying to imitate that whole process in the form of this modeling. So through this modeling, you actually represent them, and computations as well as formulations, this whole task, people actually refer to simulation. So whenever we call simulations, so it doesn't rely on any empiricism. It doesn't rely on any data which are not supported by like physical laws or physical phenomena. Simulation actually requires science. Simulation actually requires engineering approach. So both science and engineering approach, that makes the simulations very powerful and almost equivalent tool to understand process, to improve the process, and to design the process. Another advantage is that through the computer simulations, you are able to come up with many alternative options, alternative design situations, which you can tally, which you can compare. Suppose you do not know or you don't have a pilot plant or you don't have the operations available with you. You don't have the experimental operations or process operation available to you. But you know somehow that these are the physical phenomena that is actually occurring. So you can try to connect them. You can try to form the modeling task, or you can try to draw the boundary. You can try to draw the simulation tool in the form of equation setup and, you know, theory, problem description, and then ultimately solutions. Then you try to change it through some other different model configurations. So parallelly, you can solve 3-4 model with the help of computer, and you can also see which one is the better performing or which one is the best describing your actual physical process. And then you can go for actual experimental design. So this offers huge advantage in terms of time and in terms of savings, because once you have developed some, you know, or designed or commercialized some plant operations, and then you found some major blockage or major fault at some locations, you are not going to again change it and build a new plant. You will then actually rely on the computer simulations. You will actually then rely to solve that problem with the help of computer simulations. So there is the importance of this computer-aided process engineering. Process engineering people earlier have used. It is not that it invariably actually requires computer. But earlier days, the descriptions were limited. Or I would say that the scope was not there, because when the days of analog computer, let's say it's 1960, people used to rely on human intervention. Human intervention means that, let's say, there were specialized task people who used to do this, computer coding, computer programming. So chemical engineer used to give them the equations or physical phenomena or laws. They used to do the programming and then solution requires some mathematician or some computerized specialist. But nowadays, chemical engineers are so versatile that they can do the modeling, they can solve for the modeling task, and they don't require associates. They don't require other computer specialized. So after the digital computer actually came, and the ever-increasing, the speed that actually you can see in today's world, anything is possible. I mean, people are now exploring many of the different options or alternatives. Now people are trying to blend computer science and chemical engineering. The new research field are actually coming. People are calling chemi-informatics. So chemical engineering and informatics. So this is how the path is actually diverging. It started earlier days. It was only restricted to chemical engineers, process industry. Now it has computer. Once the computer actually came into picture, many expansion happened and many improvement and efficiency increased. So now I would just so this actually sums up the importance of this course and to understand and to realize what we are going to see. So I'll just briefly now share the outline of this course, and then in the form of block diagram or the explanation that I was trying to refer, I will again showcase that to you and the discussion will happen. So this is the course outline. Let me open this first. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, So this course will be taken by both Swami Babu Varanasi and myself. This is a typical objective, I mean, which we are discussing right now, and you can also see here that we'll try to emphasize more on the build-up of the model, definition of the model, the theory or the physical processes, the physics. We'll try to bring out the physics of the problem in the form of mathematical expressions or model equations. We'll also see how smartly or how, you know, efficiently we can arrange them in a natural law or natural ordering sequence, that means natural laws, cause and effect relations. So if you go in that way, that offers two advantages. This natural ordering, or naturally this what is called cause and effect relations, it helps you to realize the process, it helps you to understand what is actually happening in the whole system. At the same time, the solution that you will obtain, it would be stable. It would not give you some unrealistic solutions in that sense. So this part will be more given more emphasis. At the same time, MATLAB will be not directly taught, but the example that I will give, the solutions can be made using MATLAB. You can also use other languages or other engineering computations platform. But typically, I would suggest that understanding of this knowledge on MATLAB and Aspen is very, very essential, because once you will graduate and you will join industry, you will work in different chemical process industry or other sector, you will see that invariably people are using many coding languages or many operations, scientific computing languages. But MATLAB essentially should be known, should be, you know, definitely known to chemical engineering graduates. You will see in other semester, you will see other courses which again will teach you, or again will not teach you, again will display, or again will explain the various examples through this Aspen and MATLAB. But this is being the very first course that we'll see. So I'll try to give you as basic or as introductory in nature. So we are not supposed to solve many of the complex problem using MATLAB. But we'll introduce to this computing platform that is MATLAB, so that you can carry out the other problems that you will see in subsequent semester or other courses if you take in the next semester. So these two textbook I will typically follow. Roger Frank's Modeling and Simulation in Chemical Engineering. This is a very nice book. As I said, that since this is a first third year undergraduate, or typically this is the first attempt or first situation where actually chemical engineers gets exposed to this course, so this book has been written in that sense. So I typically like this book. At the same time, Ramirez, this book has been mostly, you know, influenced by this Roger Franks. So I have the soft copy of this Ramirez book. Time to time, as the course, you know, covers the relevant portions from this book will be shared. For example, the today's course discussion that is very nicely written in this Ramirez book, the first chapter, I'll explain that. I'll share that. I'll send that to you. And then other books, typically you can also explore this Levin, Seder and Seder. This is typically not basic course or basic textbook. It is containing many of these information, many product and process design principles. So it some kind of, I will say, advanced to this compared to this Roger Franks and Ramirez book. So you can refer to them for your improved or more understanding. And this AK Jana is one of our colleague in chemical engineering department, Professor Amiyo Kumar Jana. he has also written very nice and gave nice explanation to particularly to Aspen. So this book, Chemical Process Modeling and Computer Simulations, it is mainly discussed. The process example has been discussed with the help of Aspen. Now, coming to this topic, here I will say that this, as I said, MATLAB and Aspen, these two computing platform you should be knowing. So I will try to mostly give example using MATLAB. And as we have discussed, both myself and Sambhav Varanasi, that we'll try to give examples in such a way that both can be solved in MATLAB and Aspen so that you become familiar more. And I will mainly emphasize on MATLAB. If it requires, I will also, we'll be there. Basically, this is a joint taken by both myself and Dr. Varanasi. So we'll see how we can show you different examples, the same examples which can be solved by both MATLAB and Aspen so that you can understand better. So this through this course, our main objective that you are two things. Basically, you are able to formulate the problem. You get a comprehensive idea about the process modeling and its approach to solution. And once the solution is obtained, how to analyze the results, whether that results that you have obtained that actually relate to the processes or that actually so that you get a realistic solution, that the result that you have obtained after computations, the values are not absurd, values are actually supporting your processes, right? And like as I said, MATLAB and Aspen, typically this process simulation platform or process modeling platform, it will be introduced. So this content, I have just kept it in this way. It may vary a little bit because the examples that we'll try to cover mostly from this, because the textbook also is there where these examples can be obtained. And these are typically, chemical engineering applications where you will see that, as I said, the five chapters or five different areas where this process modeling or computer-aided process engineering is typically required, which includes fluid flow, heat transfer, mass transfer, reaction engineering, and process dynamics and control. And these five subjects are, you can also think of as a pillar, as pillar to chemical engineers. And the examples, we'll try to cover mostly this thing. So this is one thing I'll say that at the end I have tried to add one topic. So this is one suggestions that actually came from the last semester when I taught this subject. So people were more interested to see data science or this today people are more interested in doing this. So then I thought about something which is people are actually discussing in nowadays, that whether AI or different machine learning models, whether they can explain the many of the unknown concepts in chemical engineering, chemistry, physics, like that. So as I said in the beginning, that people are now trying to almost amalgamate this computer science and chemical engineering. And as the result, these different branches or different research avenues are coming up. For example, chemi informatics, people already have established or already have realized the bioinformatics. But now people are now coming to this chemical engineering domain as well. So this some introduction to neural network model will be given. So this part I'll take, this neural network model, especially the back propagation algorithm. We'll try to see the meaning, the how to solve them, how to build a model, or how that is different. The main thing is that this, except this, till this part or till this highlighted part, that actually supports, that actually comes through the physical concepts or physical laws or governing laws. So we often call them as physics-driven model. This is the kind of terminology people actually use. You will also hear from different areas that physics-driven model. But there are now terms coming that data-driven model. Now, how that is different? How that is different from the conventional modeling and simulations, right? Because not everything is AI-driven or this machine learning-driven model, but the basic, the root cannot be forgotten, right? The root is the physics-driven model or the typical process industries. But now people are trying to see the advantages of different machine learning model or AI model to solve or to get some unknown concept clear, more insights into the processes. So basically a kind of vis-a-vis comparison or vis-a-vis discussion about this data-driven model and physics-driven model. So this part I'll try to cover in the last last part of my course or lecture before Dr. Varanasi takes his course. So typically I'll cover this up to heat exchanger possibly or furnaces, something. I mean, this is a very sharp boundary is there, but discussion between myself and Varanasi will be happening and accordingly we'll carry out. So first 6 weeks, I will teach, and the next 6 weeks or 7 weeks, Dr. Varanasi will continue. Okay. So this is the typical time, Monday and Tuesday, 8 to 10. So tomorrow morning again, we'll meet. And this is the typical course lecture days. And you know all our email IDs. So any doubts or any queries over this outline? After that, I will discuss the...
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, is Aspen an open source platform?
No.
So, sir, do we have institute-provided IDs? Yes.
See, our institute or chemical engineering department have licensed versions of Aspen as well as MATLAB. Both the thing are available with our department. Now, there is a computer-aided process engineering laboratory. Actually, this is just the next semester you will do this CAPE course, right? The short form is CAPE. So in the next semester, you will do the laboratory where you will actually solve this problem, this Aspen and using Aspen and MATLAB. So that's why I said that we'll give more emphasis on the problem formulations, this natural ordering or sequences, and then the solutions you will actually do or the laboratory course that is actually happen in the fourth year, that typically happens in fourth year, first semester, they actually use this Aspen and MATLAB.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, so what I will do through this course, basically, I will show you how to, you know, use or how to, you know, access different, you know, library program or routine. For example, this, let us, you know, open that document. Maybe with that, I'll explain. Achha, any doubts over this topics or content or this textbook? General references. I'll upload this handout in the study material section. But any queries, quick queries? Okay. If not, then let me explain that two documents that I was thinking to describe, and where I'll show where I'll tell something. Yeah. Okay. So let me change this. How do I say it? No, this is not. Just give me 1 minute. Where is whiteboard? Can you see this, or it is not too small? Is it too small to read?
No, sir. It's okay.
Yes, sir.
Sir, we can zoom if we want.
Zoom.
Like there's this feature. We can zoom in if we need it.
Now is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this slide, can I further zoom it, or is it the maximum? Any idea? As a pan and zoom. Okay, fine. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah. So this different equations or this table actually showcases the the clear picture or the broad overview of different type of equations that we do see in this, and the complexity involved. That is basically the thing. Now here you can see is the analytical method. The name is actually analytical method, it is saying. So you see, one thing is that analytical approach. Now what do you mean by analytical approach? It is basically another way of quantitative understanding, right? Any physical processes or any operations that actually happens, if you can see its quantitative nature, if you can solve some equations, if you can thoroughly understand, if you want to get more insight, you have to look for analytical approach. That means you have to go for quantitative solutions, quantitative understanding, and invariably that requires the solution of many equations, many type of equations. Now this column actually indicates the different equation type of equation, as I said, algebraic, ODE, ordinary differential equation, and partial differential equations. And typically you are familiar with two type of broad divisions, like linear and nonlinear equations. Now there can be one equations, there can be several equations, there can be many equations. Similarly for nonlinear, this is the same story. Now why this trivial, easy, and essentially impossible, very difficult, impossible, these are actually written. Now, as I said, when the days were the earlier days when the scope of these computations were not much, people were actually relying on mathematics. People were actually solving analytically. That means they didn't have this different computing platform, which actually solves through numerical methods, which actually solves through any complex problem which you are not able to solve analytically, that means the typical mathematical solutions through different technique or different methods you are not able to solve, then you have to go for numerical route or numerical technique. So then the scope was also limited, and people used to describe in the form of small equations. Why? Because they need to get some solution. They need some realistic data, some realistic values. So that's why they were limited with small equations, which were or less number of equations, which are typically be possible to solve by ODE and little bit difficulty in PDE. But the standard, different solution technique as it is there in different mathematics course, so that is possible. But today's industry, or not only today's industry, in earlier days also, if you want to incorporate many degrees of freedom, if you want to incorporate the automations into your problem, into your operations, then invariably the complexity increases. The equation is, or number of equations are not one or two, three. It is maybe 100, maybe more than 100. And that actually couples many algebraic equations, many ordinary differential equations, many partial differential equations. So invariably, this falls into the category of many. And maybe linear or nonlinear. Even if it is linear, it goes to almost like impossible. So that means analytically, you will not be able to solve, but numerically, yes. That's why these computer simulations or computer different computing platform using MATLAB, Aspen, that actually came into existence. So essentially this table shows you our almost like the I can draw some boundary that this is the boundary of analytically you can actually look for. You can actually look for mathematical, standard mathematical technique or mathematical methods. You can actually solve them. But here in this part, the remaining portion, you have to go for numerical technique, where this computer aided process engineering actually come into existence, or computer aided process engineering actually become very, very useful. And you don't have to, you know, also write the library routing. For example, I don't know, maybe you are more familiar with this different numerical technique. What happened? Did you see something, some changes? Something may have changed. Anyways, what I was describing is that this complexity, as you can see, this thing is there. The numerical technique that typically this MATLAB, so MATLAB advantage is that you have this library routine that is available. For example, if you want to solve two, three simultaneous ordinary differential equations using Runge-Kutta fourth order method, then there are standard library. You can access them. So that is very advantage. So MATLAB is not only a language for computations, a language for writing, but you can also call it as a tool. You can directly access different library routines, different numerical recipes, which have this different numerical technique. For example, Runge-Kutta, Adam Bassforth, or solving by different equations, solving by different technique. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, so then let us go to this this part. So this actually I was, you know, describing in the first few minutes, where you have to. So this picture, if you see, then you will actually now be able to relate, and you will able to understand. So things will be there in your mind. So this is the typically approach, or this is the thing that we are going to understand in this course. So one should have a very clear picture about what we are actually doing. So this is the procedure for analytical approach, as I was mentioning, that this is the way people actually should look into process modeling course or the problem solutions. So it starts with definition, then the theory or the physics, the governing laws. Once you are aware of this, once you are understand that this operations is actually happening, let's say it's the heat exchanger operations, then you know these are the different phenomena that is occurring, then you will be able to write the equations relating many variables, many parameters. And then through information flow diagram, for that we'll invest the next class, that means tomorrow, how to formulate a problem with the help of information flow diagram. We'll start with very easy example, and then we'll increase the complexity. So information flow diagram will be mainly IFD, people call it SORT. We'll discuss in the next class, that is tomorrow. So then this first four is basically your problem formulation. This is your problem formulations. And this next four is kind of computations or kind of solutions that you can actually see. So this desired solutions, it is a block, basically this connecting three. So one thing is that if you're, then as I said, there is an engineering judgment, or, you know, some kind of assumptions you will actually imply, impose upon on the problem. So maybe you can directly solve them without, you know, mathematically solving. You can directly tell what is going to happen, what is the nature of this variable, or what is the nature of the output. So some kind of common sense, but typically it is much less, you know, the scope is much less because you have to ultimately solve many complex problems with many unknowns, many complexity, for example, ordinary differential equations and algebraic equations coupled many variables. So this common sense can give you some idea about the nature qualitatively. But if you want to go for qualitative, then you have to either take the help of analytical methods, maybe some mathematical equations that actually directly give you the solutions, or you have to do numerical technique using computer simulations. The third one, basically where these block computers, that actually refers to the computer simulations using MATLAB Aspen, which nothing but takes into account the numerical recipes, numerical methods. Aspen is more of a different approach. I'll not discuss that part now, but MATLAB is mainly relying on the numerical technique. So this computer simulations then actually comes into picture, and that is mostly used, that is mostly followed. And then this, once you get the solutions, then the checking is required. So checking with the help of some earlier model or some results where others have reported, or your own experimental results. So one can, you know, directly compare your output from computer simulations and experimental data. So that kind of checking is required. And if that closeness or parity is not there, then you have to improve the solutions. You have to, again, go back to this. Maybe I can add some arrow. So this checking, this is a double, both side. That means the solutions need to improve. Now, where you will actually improve? You have to go to this particular, this IFD. So that means here, one step I'll show in tomorrow, that is assumption. Okay. So this assumption, I'm very bad at, you know, writing. So these assumptions you have to maybe change, maybe you have to add some degree of freedom, or you have to ignore some term so that you get a different set of equations, you get a different kind of numerical technique or solutions that you have to apply so that you get a desired solutions. So these are the different thing that actually will require, and these two diagram that I actually explained through this course, through this lecture, this should be, you know, sufficient for your first day, you know, understanding about this course. Now, let me see if what is there in the next document. If it is related, then I'll explain. Otherwise, I'll start it from tomorrow. Maybe I can start that discussion tomorrow, the other document, which is related to this, but it is connected to different examples. So that I'll start tomorrow, and then we'll shift to information flow diagram kind of. Okay, is there any doubt over this two document that I have shown?
Sir, were you writing anything on the document, because it was not visible to us?
This particular document I was marking with red, green color. That was not visible?
No, sir, it was not.
Oh, okay. Achha, I'll try. Actually, I was trying to use the whiteboard on the PDF. Basically, I have uploaded a PDF document on the whiteboard and I was trying to mark it. Okay. Let me see if I can improve this technique. Maybe I will open the whiteboard and I'll share something. Okay, I'll work it out tomorrow. But in any case, the recording is done. So you can later on, you can see them. At least the document will be available separately. And you can also access the recorded video. So then you will be able to relate, in my opinion.
So I think the whiteboard is not included in the recordings. So it's more advice that you use PDF, like you use Explorer to view the PDF. Even if you make changes there, you can save it.
Ujjwal, you can zoom out. It's visible on zooming out.
Let us do one thing. First, let me stop the recording. That is important.